at the size of that print. With the big toenail up front, I bet you that's Asian elephant.
You know, there's a very large animal out here that we need to be aware of. It's the king of this jungle, as far as I'm concerned.
This pretty much confirms my suspicions. We have big piles of poop. This stuff is not that old.
Asian elephants are not only the world's second largest land animal, they are highly aggressive when something invades their territory. But what they leave behind can be a valuable resource.
Since an elephant is such a poor processor of what it eats, technically there could be nutritional value within the poop, believe it or not. Seeds, nuts, etc., that just go through and out the back end. So it's called second harvest. There's entire indigenous peoples where in scant areas like the desert, they would poop on flat rocks and then come back months later and dig through their own poop for seeds of whatever they were eating. I don't think there's necessarily a need for second harvest here, but it was done as a survival tactic for real. So pray that you never have to do it.
It's almost like a football.
Another use for elephant poop, essentially this is compressed fuel. I could put a coal from a fire in here, and it's a way to carry fire. So what that means is potential resources, and we can do stuff with this dung.
That's an incredibly big butt.
This tender bundle is made from a little bit of elephant dung, fishtail palm, and a little bit of vine. It's a jungle soup. Next, I'm taking the battery out of the cell phone. You can see there's a little minus there, a little positive there. I'm gonna take my steel wool, touch one end to here, and I'm gonna touch the other end to there. And if this has any juice, it'll glow and burn down like a glow worm. I don't know if this battery has any juice though, because the cell phone won't work.
Steel wool acts as a conductor to carry current from the positive to the negative end of a battery.
Here's the moment of truth.
The crossed electrical charge heats the steel wool's fine strands to a point of combustion.
There we go. That cell phone battery and the steel wool are essentially our matches, and I want to protect those matches. It's zip tight, the baggie seems to be holding air, and that's what you do, because we might need that again. That's what we in survival land call common sense.
The plan is I'm gonna take two torches. When I get to the first one burning out, at that point I'm gonna light the second one, and I'm coming back.
Ready to rock and roll, man.
One in, one out, that's the plan.
Be careful, man.
I'm gonna investigate this cave, because if I can see light from around that corner 50 yards away, then it's probably a shortcut to the other side of this mountain other than walking around.
No matter the path Dave and Cody take, a survival priority is to prepare for the unexpected and bring the most important resources with them.
Since I've already made fire, I want to try to transport it. What I'm doing is just taking some of the jungle vine and just making a container to hold this piece of elephant dung. Dung is compressed fuel, basically. It's like a big fuel tablet. So it should burn and just smolder and smolder. I can stick my entire finger right in there, and that's where I'll put an ember. With a piece of dung like this, it might last 5-6 hours. And I guarantee you a torch is not gonna last that long.
I see an opening, man. It's light.
How far back?
I mean, it's hard to judge distance in a cave, man.
And you guesstimate? I mean, let's say one of these lasts 10 minutes.
I would say torches like that, we need two torches to get through there.
Well, do you think it's worth doing this?
I mean, it's the only choice we have, I think. There is light back there.
I don't know, man.
Gotta make a decision here. We gotta get her done, or we ain't gonna get her done.
Okay. Anyone who goes into a cave that has flowing water is potentially gonna lose their life. Limestone is highly erodible rock, so it can be very sharp, it can be very weak.
You ready to get the fire?
Yeah.
All right, man.
And the main reason I'm even contemplating going to this cave is because Dave said he saw a light source.
We got four torches, I hope that's enough.
What I'm worried about is, you know, if Dave actually saw a light source.
So how much further do you think it is?
I want our second torch, so, you know, it can't be too much further.
It's psychologically terrifying to be in potential darkness in a place you've never been in before, and you don't know where that journey is gonna end, like miners trapped in a cave.
Hey, Cody.
What?
Look here. Light. See it?
Yeah, we gotta be over halfway there. I can see the light, man.
Well, let's just walk toward it. Let's just go.
Hey, we got a problem here, brother.
What?
Whoa. See that waterfall? That looks pretty deep, man. One of us is gonna have to go down there and find out how deep that is. If it's over our heads, we might have to make a plan B.
You can see that it goes down probably 6 feet. And below that, you know, I can't see with the torch the bottom.
We don't know the depth of the water, and neither one of us can swim for very long holding torches. I don't think it's worth it.
But we don't have time to fart around in here. We got X amount of torchlight. I see light at the end of the tunnel, so I'm going down there, and we're moving on. Cody probably wondering if I judged the distance correctly on recon, you know, and he's thinking, oh man, I hope this wasn't a mistake. I hope this wasn't a mistake, because I would be thinking the same thing. In a survival situation like this, you've got to rely on each other 100% of the time, because if you can't trust your life in that person's hands, then you don't want to be there with them.
In a partnership situation, your most important resource will be your partner. They can be your greatest ally or your worst enemy. You know, I trust Dave, but the thing I care about is that light doable with the human body through it, or is it light at the top of the cave where it's 40 feet up? You just don't know.
Oh,
you all right? A lot of light out here, man.
Holy cow, dude.
Fire is not just for a camp with the beanie weenies, it's a resource. What I'm worried about is the steel wool and the battery. It's the way to make fire. But the backpack is wet. Whether stuff in the backpack is wet, I don't know.
It looks like there's water in this bag. I probably smashed it up against a rock when I was leaning, pushing in there.
It's totally soaked. I don't think the seal was done. That's not the way I sealed the bag. That's, you know,